Let's make a crane from the clay. We'll start out with some clay. This is about a package worth of Primo clay that I've rolled out with a roller to get it, start to condition it and make it so it's thin enough to go through the pasta machine once we've rolled it out. So first we're going to put it through the pasta machine at the thickest setting, folding it in half and putting it through again. Okay, now that's at the thickest setting. I'm going to take it down one setting, three on my pasta machine, or the third thinnest setting. Now I'm going to take my cane slices and lay those out on my sheet of clay. Okay, and then I want to just do quickly roll over the surface of the clay with my roller to help begin to incorporate those cane slices into the clay. And I want to trim down the excess clay. Okay, and we're just going to remove that and go back to the pasta machine. We're going to go back to number two and put it through. Turn it 90 degrees. Go through on number three. I go down to number six on my machine. At this point, it is about a millimeter in thickness, and it's what I have found to be about the best thickness for folding a crane from clay. What I'm going to use is a template to get my square, and I'm going to lay that over the clay and just using my knife, cut around the very edges of that template and trim away the excess clay. And we have a nice sheet of clay. Now, I have to prepare it so I can fold it. And the first thing I do is take some cornstarch, and this is a cheesecloth that I've bunched up and wrapped a rubber band around, and I'm gonna dip it in the cornstarch and then dust my surface fairly liberally. Not, you know, too much. You're going to see it, but it's not going to be a thick coating of clay, of cornstarch on the clay. So you're going to dust it on one side, and I'm going to do my first fold. And this is really just bringing this corner over and then lightly patting along that fold. I don't want to press down. I just want to start to define where that fold's going to be. And I'm going to open it up and flip it over, and I am going to get some more cornstarch and dust the other side of the clay, because both sides need to be covered with the cornstarch to keep it from sticking. Okay, a fairly thin, even coating. Now I want to do my next two folds that are preparatory folds, and I'm going to go across and just do a gentle mountain fold and then go in the other direction. Okay, and opening it up, and we're ready to actually start folding the form. I'm gonna flip it over so the pattern side is down, and then I wanna bring this corner down here and this corner down here, and I'll flip it around so you can see better. I'm gonna bring this corner over in, and this corner in, and open up here and bring it down like that. Okay, and you can see the folds are still gently formed. They're not sharp and crisp like they would be on a piece of paper. And I'm not going to press it any further than this. Now, normally if I'm folding a piece of paper, I'm going to be folding this edge into the center. I don't want to do that because I want to handle the clay as little as possible. And I don't need to do that because the clay is more ready to conform than the paper is. So I'm just going to open directly up, and as I get to a point where these sides start to pull in, I'm going to start pushing them in towards the center here. And what I want to do is take this edge here and bring it into the center line and just carefully finding that line and starting to create Again, just very gentle folds, not pushing the clay very hard. Okay, and we're going to flip it over and do the same thing on the other side. Bringing it up, nudging the clay over and bringing in towards the center from each side. Finding that point at the tip. You can see I'm handling the clay very gently. I don't want to handle it much because the heat from my hands can make the clay more sticky and more difficult to handle. So all my touch of the clay has to be very light and gentle.